Number two on our top problems that people find setting up Camera Lucida, the legendary OSMO reflector for the iPad. Comes in a little box like this, costs about £10, $12. I have a few of them, give them away to friends and family. There we go, it's a little device, that's all it is, very, very simple. It is a curved piece of plastic with an angled mirror. That is it, all it is. So the angled mirror enables you to project the image that you're drawing into the front of the iPad, which we'll have a look at. So number two confusion is the OSMO device. This one fits most of them. It has a little screw in the side and you can adjust that screw depending upon the version of iPad that you have. But the way, or the best way of doing it, as Peter will say, is when you put it on the iPad, if you have one of the newer iPads, just pull it up slightly to adjust it so that the mirror is reflecting the camera on the iPad. The whole purpose of this is to reflect the image. So there's the OSMO device, £10, $12. Get one of these, get several. They're very, very useful, carry them around. How does that work? Well, it fits onto the top of your iPad. Here's your iPad in portrait mode and the OSMO just pushes on over the top of the camera. So I put it on there and push, that's it. That is now in position. If you have one of the modern iPads, you'll find that the camera is slightly higher. So you may have to lift up the OSMO slightly. As you can see, I can either pull it up slightly or I can push it all the way down like that. And this iPad is about 7 years old. Still works great for Camera Lucida, and I push it all the way down. So in conjunction with my stand, I have my iPad in the right position with the OSMO device, and I'm now set up to start using Camera Lucida. So issue number two is the OSMO. You need the OSMO, but a front camera, you do not need the OSMO stand. Okay, that's important. Okay, let's move on to number three.